What is up, guys? David here again, bringing you more Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Man, been pretty busy lately, for starters. Well, still working out the kinks. I've got a brand new microphone for the streams and voice work in general. That doesn't mean I'm retiring this mic I have here, which is the Wave 3. I'm actually going to be using this mic for my new laptop, which I'll be getting tomorrow, along with some new pop filters, for both mics. That way, so I get the best quality possible when I'm in the room and such. So, yeah, a lot of good news all around. And, still no confirmation yet, but I believe of good faith that I've completed my very first commercial. So, I actually did my first gig. Pretty cool, honestly. Not trying to brag, but I'm pretty blessed that I was able to get that chance. So, yeah, pretty exciting stuff. Things are looking up, and slowly but surely, I'll become an official voice actor sooner or later. So, if I'm not already. but anyway, let's get right into it. The last time I checked, I believe we just finished up the second day of the trial, so now we're on the final day of investigating for Turnabout Samurai. Oh, that was a close one, huh, Mia?
Really, too bad. I'm sorry I missed it.
Maya? So what happened? Well, I think I got a pretty good idea who did it. Now all I need is a motive and proof.
Wow, good going, Nick.
Under the initial trial system, tomorrow is the last day we have.
Initial trial? What's that?
That's the new court system they introduced 2 or 3 years ago. They had so many cases in the system, they decided to speed the whole process up.
So under that system, trials have to end in 3 days?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, we've no time to waste.
Well, we have no time to waste, excuse me. I don't get it, Maya. Why would Mr. Hammer steal the Steel Samurai costume?
What? You mean Mr. Hammer was wearing the costume?
Yeah.
But Mr. Hammer was the victim, Nick. Why would he go through the trouble of stealing it?
That's what we have to find out.
What happened with the director's testimony?
Well, it's pretty clear that the producer and the director were both in the trailer.
Huh.
Which means that the killer has to be one of them.
Really? Why?
Because the real scene in the crime was Studio 2, where that trailer is.
What?
Was Maya always this excitable? Well, have you noticed anything that might help us?
I can't see what's going on when Mia is here, so no, I haven't noticed anything.
Right.
Maybe we should go talk to WP?
Talk to Powers, huh? Might as well. Yeah. Not sure how much more help he can be. Pretty much gave us all the freaking clues.
Mr. Wright, you did very well again today. Thank you.
Oh, thanks. Can you not look like you're about to burst into tears?
Wow, Nick, you must really wowed him in there.
And could you wipe that grin off your face?
Hey, WP, only one day left. Let's make it count.
Yes. Though there's not really anything I could do to help.
I'm not really sure what I could do either.
Please, this is no laughing matter. Can you tell me more about Miss Vasquez?
Oh, the producer? She's well respected in the industry. They say she's a genius.
A genius?
She's been at Global Studios for 5 years now. Right or wrong, nobody dares tell her different these days.
Why is that?
Ever since she came on board, we had nothing but hits. Global Studios was on its knees, but she picked it up and made it shine. Oh, and...
And? What?
Nothing. Forget it. I've only heard rumors anyhow.
Can you tell me anything about Mr. Manella?
Well, he used to be a minor straight-to-video director, and something in his work caught Vasquez's eye. She brought the Steel Samurai idea to him. Oh, everyone knows the name Salmonella. I hear he's pretty much at her back and call, though. Whenever she says jump, he asks how high and all that.
I can imagine being at her back and call, but I can't imagine him jumping.
I was worried about Mr. Hammer. He was a big star back in the day, right? But then he'd just drop off the face of the earth.
Oh, yes, you're right. In fact, he was my role model when I started in this business. But he just stopped talking.
Yeah, talking.
But he just stopped thinking about big roles. That's when he began appearing in little productions at Global.
How could he do that? I was really looking forward to a sequel to Samurai Summer.
He just gave up being a star 5 years ago. Actually, now that I think about it, that was right when Miss Vadcast came to Global.
5 years ago? Have you seen this, Mr. Powers?
What's that? I've never seen these steel samurais in my life.
These are the steel samurais that appear in at live shows, and Fanboy collected all these pictures himself.
Seeing things like this really makes me think. I mean, so much of these kids, you know?
Well, there's really nothing more we can really talk to Powers about anything. Oh, no. Anyone but her. Her voice kind of kills my throat. Oh. She's quiet. The old windbag sure is quiet today. You know, this place is really peaceful like this. Nick, I think her guard's down.
Yeah.
I bet we could even eat those donuts in the guard station if you wanted.
You eat, you die.
Whew, she's alive. I was wondering about D. Vasquez, the producer.
Oh, the studio bigwits love her. So she always gets her way.
She seems bitter. Do you not like the producer?
Look, the studio people don't want me talking about her, so sorry.
Can I ask you about Salmonella, the director?
Sal? He's a soft pushover. Does whatever Vasquez tells him to. She treats him like dirt, but I think he likes it.
Huh? Why would anyone like being treated like dirt? That doesn't make any sense, does it, Nick? No. No, it doesn't, Maya. About Mr. Hammer.
Arr! I heard about what you said today. Cheeky whippersnapper. Poor old Hammer. You dragged his star down from the sky and stomped on it. Calling him a criminal. A thief. I won't forget this.
Uh-oh, she's pissed this time. Really pissed this time.
You listen to me, whippersnapper. My poor old Hammer would never do such a thing. Why would he steal Powers' causes so he'd sneak by me? He will never stoop so low. It's impossible.
Okay, let's get the hell out of here. Think back, Nick, to the day of the murder. Mr. Hammer put on the Steel Samurai costume. Then he left from here to go to Studio 2.
Right.
But why? I wonder if someone called him. Like the director or the producer?
We won't know until we find out.
Oh, speak of the bitch.
Hey, Nick, it's Miss Vadcast.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Maya, you should at least try to be polite.
I'm watching the clouds.
That's all she had to say, apparently.
Excuse me. Mr. Hammer came here on the day of the murder and...
Shh!
Hmm?
Perhaps you didn't hear me. I'm watching the clouds. I'm not interested in talking to you.
Do something, Nick. She's really ticking me off.
Oh, dear.
Mr. Powers wasn't the killer. You don't have to cancel the Steel Samurai.
I think I'm tired of the Steel Samurai.
You did it. Nick, she did it. She's the killer. My fable life speaks to me. I know it. I know it.
Oh, dear. I was wondering if you could tell me about Mr. Manila.
If you must talk about that man, perhaps you could talk about it in the trailer.
Hello, Pasha. Welcome, good sir.
By yourselves.
Oh dear. I don't think she's gonna talk to us unless we have some evidence.
Wasn't the assistant cleaning up yesterday? Funny, it still seems pretty messy in here.
I guess she was still on a high from getting that rare car she needed. Lots of traveling. We are going to the employee area.
I guess they're not filming today either. I did want to see them filming just one time.
This trial will be over and done by tomorrow. You could come see them film later.
I guess. This is where you found that bottle of sleeping pills, right?
Uh-huh.
I wonder if there are any other clues lying around.
No, no touching! Oh, sorry, pal.
Oh, hit the wrong button.
Didn't mean to frighten you.
Didn't mean? I almost had a heart attack.
I guess I could be a little dramatic at times. I suppose the actor in me.
Dramatique, indeed.
Anyway, I'm here to examine the plate on that table.
Wait, are you looking for sleeping pills?
Yeah, pal, the traces thereof. Alright.
So you're looking for traces of the sleeping pills. How?
For a thorough examination, I gotta take the plate back to the precinct. But I have the capabilities to make a cursory examination right here. Our science guy gave me some testing solution. This reacts to these sleeping pills, see? If there's traces, it'll change color.
Wow, neat. Well, Detective Gumshoe, what are you waiting for?
Now, everything in due time, pal. Well, the testing solution on the plate changed color, all right.
So there was sleeping pills. So the food on this plate had been laced with sleeping pills.
Looks like it.
How goes your investigation?
To tell the truth, it's a real mess, pal. Some people think we should pursue the case we already have against Powers. And some people think we should switch suspects.
What do you mean, Detective Gumshoe?
Well, pal, I hate to admit it, but I'm not sure I buy the case against Mr. Powers anymore. I feel kind of bad for Mr. Edgeworth, though.
How's Edgeworth doing anyway?
Mr. Edgeworth's out of control. He was in the waiting room and he crushed this paper cup with hot coffee in it.
Whoa.
Talk about burns, pal.
Wow, the fury of Edgeworth.
Yeah, crushing paper cups. Cups? Bottles? Say, whatever happened with that empty bottle?
Oh, the bottle sleeping pills. Well, I got some good news for you about that. They found the victim Jack Hammer's prints on the bottle.
So that means...
Yep, it sounds like the one who put Powers asleep was none other than the victim.
So I was right. Yep. He drugged him, all right. So Powers is innocent.
Looking like Will Powers was drugged. I'm going to go back to the precinct to do some more detailed tests.
You're being very free of your information today, Detective.
Well, don't go telling anyone this, pal. But I was kind of impressed at today's trial, too. Most lawyers wouldn't give up after that director's testimony. I think if I had anyone but you up there, Powers would have been done for by now.
Detective, about that bottle.
Oh, that? Talk about embarrassing, pal. I can't believe I missed that on my first sweep for evidence. Don't know how I can apologize to Mr. Edgeworth.
It must be tough being a detective with all that responsibility.
Ugh.
I don't think there's really much else we can talk with Gumshoe right now. Anything in the dressing room?
Oh, hello. What are you doing here? Oh, I was just cleaning up the dressing room. I guess WP won't be using it anymore, so...
What?
Why?
But Diapy's innocent. Yes, and I'm really grateful for all you've done. But this week is the last episode of The Steel Samurai. What? No!
Oh, well. I was wondering if I could ask you about Mr. Hammer.
Yes? On the day of the murder, he went to Studio 2. Huh? I thought he went to Studio 1. He stole the Steel Samurai costume, too. What? Why would Mr. Hammer do something like that? Oh, I guess the rumor must be true, then.
The rumor?
Yeah, Miss Vadkez, that producer, had some kind of hold on Hammer. She had some dirt on him. He'd do anything she said, apparently.
Some dirt?
What dirt? Dirt, you know, bad stuff. I know what dirt means. About 5 years ago, they were filming a movie starring Mr. Hammer. They were using the new studio, Studio 2. Some sort of accident happened during filming. After that, they never used Studio 2 again. They left the film set the way it was, too.
The film set? Was that trailer part of the film set, then?
What do you mean, The Last Steel Samurai?
I know it's a shock, but nothing can be done to save it now. Whoever really did kill Mr. Hammer also signed the Steel Samurai's death warrant.
Now, no! Also, I hear that Global Studios is going to change its programming. They're not going to make kids shows anymore.
What? Why?
I don't know. It's sad, but that's what Global Studios decided.
Why aren't they going to make kids shows anymore?
The studio bigwigs don't want the Steel Samurai around anymore. They want to forget all this ever happened. They want it quiet, you understand?
How could they just do that?
What about all the kids who love the Steel Samurai?
It's okay. I'm sure the kids will be fine. They'll find a new hero to follow.
No, they can't be true. If the program just ends, they'll be heartbroken for sure.
Nick, say something.
Yeah. I think evidence rather than words is called for here. Here, take a look at this.
And this is...
A fan collected all these photographs. The kids love The Steel Samurai. The show shouldn't be canceled just so some adults can save face. I would think you would understand that better than anyone.
You're right.
Okay. But what can I do?
Well, for starters, you could tell me something. Tell me what it is that Glow Studios is so intent on hiding. Tell me about this accident 5 years ago.
Okay.
What happened 5 years ago, I wonder? Oh yeah, Pasha, I said in the beginning of the stream right before you showed up. I did my official first commercial. So my voice work and my voice work stuff is underway, more or less. So, yeah, good shit. What the fuck? Hold on a second. I'm gonna go blow my nose. For some reason, my nose is a little clogged up. I'll be right back. Okay, that's a lot better. Holy shit. If I didn't clear out my nose, my throat would have been really... So, and also got a new microphone. I haven't got it set up just yet, but it'll be all set up by tomorrow. So, here we go. Can you tell us what happened 5 years ago?
Well, I can tell you what I've heard. Apparently, 5 years ago, someone died. And it was Hammer's fault.
Someone died? It was an accident, of course. Anyway, the producer, Miss Vasquez, managed to hush it up. And that's the dirt she had on Mr. Hammer. And that's why Mr. Hammer would do anything Miss Vasquez asked him to do. But it was an accident, right? Why didn't they just make it public? Well, you know Mr. Hammer was a big star back then. They were afraid about what would happen to his career if work got out. I see. You know who knows more about this? Miss Oldbag. She was here at the studios back then, you know. Thanks. We'll try asking her. If she'll talk. And I think we know exactly who to talk to now.
Why, you're still slinking around? If you like the place so much, why don't you take over for me?
The old Windbag doesn't look so good.
Everybody's doing their darnest to forget Hammer. Who do they think made Global Studios what it is today? Hammer. It's all due to Hammer.
She's starting to froth at the mouth, Nick. Maybe we should keep a safe distance? 5 years ago. I want to ask you about 5 years ago.
Hmm? Who told? Who did you hear that from? Nichols.
Nichols? Nichols? Nichols, Nick. Penny Nichols. That assistant we talked to.
Oh, right. Anyway, we heard about the accident. It was during filming of Jack Hammer. He killed a man, didn't he?
Whippersnappers! Dredging up dirt on someone's past like that, and the recently departed, no less. I suppose you think this is fun?
No, I'm just doing my job to protect Mr. Powers.
And you claim that Hammer stole Powers' costume. You expect me to believe that rubbish? Or do you have some kind of proof?
Proof that Hammer stole Powers' costume? I have proof. I'm sorry, Miss Oldbag, but I do have proof. I can prove that Mr. Hammer stole Mr. Powers' costume. Here's my proof.
What? What's a little empty bottle supposed to prove?
It's a bottle of sleeping pills with Mr. Hammer's fingerprints on it.
What does that prove? I'm sure old Hammer had some sleepless nights. Where's your proof that he used those pills on Powers?
It's the steak plate. Mr. Powers ate a T-bone steak for lunch, correct?
Well, yes. So?
This is the plate that he used to eat that steak. There are traces of sleeping pill powder on the plate.
I see. Poor, poor Hammer. You did wrong, Hammer. Rest your soul. Miss Oldbag? Okay, you win. I'll talk. I'm tired, you see. Tired of holding it all in. Miss Oldbag? You're right. 5 years ago, there was an accident. A fatal accident. What's worse, a paparazzi took a photo of it. A photo, well, it caused quite a stir. And guess who made it all better? Vasquez. She has ties to the mafia. She silenced that paparazzi. That was the beginning. After that, she became a force to be reckoned with here at the studio. I see. But you have to understand, poor old Hammer never meant any harm to anyone. Miss Oldbag. Hold on a minute. Poor Miss Oldbag. Here, take this. A photograph?
Oh, god damn.
Wait a second. This is the picture.
Is this the trailer in Studio 2?
Hammer was supposed to fight with a bad guy on the top of those stairs there. He pushed the other actor and the man fell onto the flower box fence.
And landed right onto the fucking spiked fence.
Well, how did you get this? It was a long time ago. I don't feel much like talking about it.
I understand. Well, we have the proof to finally talk to Vasquez. So let's present this to her. Let's see what she's got to say now.
She's not even looking. Where?
What?
Where did you get that? Old bag.
Old?
She means the security lady, Miss Old Bag, Nick.
Right. Anyway, Miss Vasquez, you hid this incident from the press, didn't you? And you used it to control Mr. Hammer.
The wind.
Uh-huh.
It's gotten stronger, don't you think? The wind. Your conversation interests me. Let's talk about it more inside the trailer.
Let's crack my neck. Pop, crack my neck.
Nick, she went inside the trailer.
And here it is. Here's the proof right here. Right here. The bent up fence post that killed whoever that was that D. Vasquez liked a lot. We can't go to Studio One, so to trailer.
You came. Well then, what was that you were talking about?
Why is she so eager to talk all of a sudden? Miss Vasquez, you were using that accident. You were blackmailing Mr. Hammer so you could control him, weren't you? That's why he was doing kid shows for petty change.
So I'm a blackmailer now.
Well, that's what it was, wasn't it? I mean, sure, it was an accident, but you used it to drag Mr. Hammer down from his rightful place as a star.
Oh? I haven't pulled anyone down from anywhere. Mr. Hammer's career went sour of his own accord.
But you were the cause. You pressured him. And to think it was just an accident.
Excuse me. What is this all about? You keep saying accident. Accident. How are you so sure?
What do you mean?
Must I spell everything out for you? Think. What would it be if it wasn't an accident?
No. No way. You mean Mr. Hammer did it on purpose? That is what I mean. Where's your proof? Can you prove it?
Just think. Would he have let me run his life for 5 years over a mere accident?
And I ran him hard, believe you me. But the security lady said it was an accident.
Oh, well, she was a big fan of Hammer's, you see. She jumped on the reporter who brought that photo into the studio. She wrenched it out of his hand, she did. Gave him a few bruises, too.
So that's why she had the photo. She's an old fool. Of course. All the reporter would need is the negatives. He could have made a copy. But he didn't. The only copy of that photo is the one you hold. Give it to me. Now.
What? This is value as it... Boys.
Uh-oh. She really has ties to the Mafia all of a sudden. I hope you don't know the Godfather. You know? Who are they?
Professionals. They're good at erasing various things. What do you think? Would you like to be a race?
What?
The trial ends tomorrow. How unfortunate. It's a shame you'll have to miss it.
Tell me why. Why do you want this photograph so badly? This is Mr. Hammer's dirt, no? Why should D. Vasquez care about it at all?
I'm sure you'll have plenty of time to think about that where you're going. So long, friends. Boys, a race away.
No! Hold it right there! I heard everything, pal! D. Vasquez, you're coming down to the precinct with me now! Alright, Gumshoe.
Not bad. Very well. It appears this contest will be decided tomorrow, then. In court. I'll be looking forward to it.
Oh, we're so gonna looking forward to kicking your ass. Hey, you okay, pal?
Sorry I was a little late with my entrance. I don't get many chances to practice that sort of thing.
Detective Gumshoe, thank you, thank you, thank you. I was really scared.
Huh? Don't mention it, pal. Just doing my job.
Detective Gumshoe?
Sorry, Shiz. I wanted to say that line ever since I became a detective. Okay, I got one more job to do today. I'm sure we'll run into each other again soon.
Well, Nick, it looks like we're getting close to the bottom of this.
And who's at the bottom? D. Vasquez.
Not again. Elgato, why? Why? Why you gotta be like this?
I swear to God, like, I need to, like, have, like, a better, like, way to do a recording setup, because this 4K 60 plus or whatever is just not cutting it. There we go, we're back. To be continued. All right, we're almost near the end of this case. Okay. All right, October 20th, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 4.
Rubble, 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 I want to go back home already, Rubble.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Today will be the final day of this trial. I hope both the prosecution and the defense will be able to present decisive evidence. Very well, Mr. Edgeworth. Your opening statement.
In yesterday's session, the defense presented us with a new theory for this case. He claims that the scene of the crime was, in fact, Studio 2. Today, I will call on people present in the Studio 2 trailer that day. From their testimonies, the truth will become clear.
Very well.
Edgeworth seems a bit on edge today.
Rubble, 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 why are we even still here, Rubble?
You may call your first witness, Mr. Edgeworth.
The prosecution calls Miss D. Vasquez to the stand. Miss D. Vasquez is a producer who was present in the Studio 2 trailer that day. And there she is, the bitch. Will the witness state her name and occupation?
D. Vasquez, I am a producer for Global Studios.
On the day of the murder, you were in the trailer in Studio 2.
As everyone here knows, yes. I dislike needless banter. If you must pontificate, do it when I'm not here.
Very well, Miss Vasquez. Please give the court your testimony concerning the day of the murder.
Nick, I know she did it. Make her pay.
Right. If she's guilty, I'll catch her with her pants down, so to speak.
You would want to see her pants down, wouldn't you, Phoenix?
I entered the trailer, a little before noon. The meeting began at 12 p.m. sharp, and ended at 4 p.m. There was to be a rehearsal afterwards, so we went to Studio 1. I was fatigued, so I had Sal take me. At 2:30, we took a 15-minute break in the meeting. Sal and I ate T-bone steaks on the table in front of the trailer. We found Hammer's body later when we all went to Studio 1. That's all.
I have a question about one part of your testimony. You were fatigued, so you had Sal take you?
The van.
There's
a van at Studio 2. I had him take me in that. I thought it might be risky to walk, what with that monkey's head toppling over.
I see. So they... Wait a minute. It's all coming back to me. All right.
I see. Very well. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
This is the final battle, Nick. Let's do it.
Let's go. A little before noon. Me begin at 4:00. There was to be a rehearsal after, so we went to Studio 1. Let's press this one. And what were you doing during that time?
Don't hit your desk. It irritates me.
Yeah, Mr. Wright. Oops.
It was a 15-minute break.
Oh, that was it? Objection! Yeah, I knew it. As I thought. You claim you ate a T-bone steak. But I say you did not.
What's this now, Mr. Wright?
Look at this.
It's a plate.
This plate was on the table in the employee area. As you can see, a large bone has been left behind. Mr. Wright, need I remind you it was a T-bone steak? Exactly my point. Remember, if you will. Miss Vasquez, Mr. Manila ate a table outside the trailer. And if you look, there's nothing on the plates. Yet there were no bones left on the plates. The plates were bare. Ugh. Miss Vasquez? Tell me, how can a person eat a T-bone steak and not leave the bone? I think I know how. You didn't eat the steak. You didn't eat any steak during that break. You took your steak and threw it somewhere, like that incinerator.
Eh.
I see. Then what was Miss Vasquez doing during her break?
Isn't it obvious, Your Honor? Meeting the Steel Samurai. She was meeting with the Steel Samurai.
Order! Are you saying?
Yes, Your Honor.
More water.
As Miss Vasquez left the trailer to eat her steak, she ran to the Steel Samurai. And then you did it. You killed him with your own hands.
Yeah.
Mr. Wright, isn't that a little presumptuous?
What kind of stunt are you trying to pull, Wright?
Let him claim what he wants. You say I did it?
Yes.
Fascinating. And here I was worrying that today would be as boring as all the rest. Very well. Let us have a battle of wits, you and I. Any day, Vasquez. Good luck, Nick. Let's see. What was that murder weapon again? Ah, yes. The samurai spear.
Yes?
I am, as you should see, a woman of petite stature. How could I possibly use that heavy spear as a weapon?
You couldn't, could you? Because technically, she's right. But the thing is, the spear is technically not the murder weapon. I think you would have a great deal of difficulty using that as a weapon. Pretty much anyone would.
Huh. You see?
Yes. However, that has no bearing on this case.
Meaning?
The samurai spear was not the murder weapon.
What?
She's like, huh?
What is the meaning of this? The spear was found lying next to the victim's body.
I have proof, Your Honor. I can prove that the samurai spear was not used as a murder weapon. It's this photo right over here. The 5-year-old photo. What happened back 5 years ago has happened again here. Fucking pure irony.
Huh?
Oh, shit.
Oops.
It's technically supposed to be this, but I fucked up. It's the samurai spear itself. I present my proof, the so-called murder weapon. But that is the murder weapon. Not so fast. Remember that this spear broke during the morning action scene run-through. But someone fixed the spear. It was the security lady. She fixed it with duct tape. Now tell me, how is it possible for someone to stab a man who is wearing a thick costume with this through the chest? Okay, so he actually has a good point.
Order! Order!
Mr. Wright, what are you driving at? Think about what you're...
Silence. I'm the one testifying here and I will be heard. Are you quite sane? Are you even aware of what you're saying? If the samurai spear was not the murder weapon, Then pray tell what was. How was Hammer killed?
Well, Mr. Wright, can you tell us what weapon was used to kill the murderer?
I can tell you. Would I make a claim like that if I couldn't tell you what the murder weapon was?
I'm afraid your confidence can sometimes be unfounded, Mr. Wright. Very well, let's see this murder weapon then.
Is it this one now? Yes! Look at this photo.
What is this? Why, that's Jack Hammer standing at the top of the stairs. Order! Order! If I cannot have order, this trial will be suspended! Mr. Wright, what is this all about?
This photograph is from 5 years ago. There was an unfortunate accident at Global Studios. This is a photo of that very accident. Not a word of this was leaked to the outside. It was a close-kept secret at the studios.
What does this have to do with the current case?
Mr. Edgeworth, you still can't see it? See the fallen man in this photo? See how the fence post pierced him through the chest?
What? Are you saying?
Yes. What happened 5 years ago has happened again.
Has happened again! Ah! Mr. Wright, continue.
It's 2:30 p.m. on the day of the murder. Miss Divac has meets Jack Hammer outside the Studio 2 trailer. Then she did it. She pushed Mr. Hammer off the stairs onto the fence. Just like Mr. Hammer had himself done 5 years ago. Though whether she did it on purpose or by accident, I cannot say.
In other words, the victim, Mr. Hammer, he died in the same way that he caused another man to die. 5 years ago?
Precisely. Ironic, isn't it?
Very creative, Mr. Wright. I could use a man like you on my script writing staff. You deny that what I say is true? Mr. Wright, let's say for the sake of argument that Hammer died at the trailer, as you say. Yet the body was found in Studio One, was it not? And in the evil magistrate's costume, no less. Are you then claiming that I carried the body to Studio One and returned to the trailer all in the space of a 15-minute break? How could I dispose of the body?
The break in the meeting at the trailer lasted 15 minutes from 2:30 to 2:45. Could Jack Hammer have been pushed off the stairs to his death, then carried to Studio One and placed inside his costume? There wasn't enough time.
Indeed. Well, Mr. Wright, how could she have dealt with the body?
She had another way. What if she had another way to carry the body, other than with her own hands?
For instance...
Actually, for that matter, there was no need for her to do the deed in 15 minutes. And there was a way for you to carry that body.
Interesting. Let's hear it then.
Mr. Wright, please show us how she carried the body.
It's the van that was just presented. She used the van to transport the body to Studio One in pretty quick time. Miss Vasquez, you carried the body to Studio One.
What the heck is that noise?
Oh, if you wonder what the heck that noise is. Yeah, you can kind of hear it. It's the washer and dryer literally across from me. So that's why it's going making that weird noise. Anyway.
And you used the studio van to do it.
Dun, 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 dun. Recall your testimony. There was to be a rehearsal after, so we went to Studio One. I was mistaken. I had Tell take me. There was a van there, right? I had Tell drive me.
There you go.
You used a van to carry the body to Studio One. Then, before everyone else got there, you put the body into the magistrate costume. Hold on, Wright. Don't forget it was Sal Manella that drove the van. Are you suggesting that Mr. Manella was a conspirator? Of course he was. Of course Salmonella was to have been a conspirator. The body had to be placed in the van and put into the costume. There's no way Miss Vasquez could have done that alone. Also, don't forget that they had disposed of the Steel Samurai costume. They had to, because it was covered in Mr. Hammer's blood. They probably burned it in that small incinerator. Well, Miss Vasquez, shall I continue?
No need. You're smarter than you look, Mr. Wright. I lose. You win. It was fun.
I win? I'm not sure. Something's not right. So what happens next? Don't hum me! Don't you have anything to say?
What would you like me to say?
Huh? I lost? Something like that?
I just said that.
Wait a minute. So you mean, D. Vasquez, so it was you. You killed Jack Hammer.
Who can say?
Huh?
Are you sure I did? Mr. Wright, we just engaged in a battle of wits. In the result of that battle, you proved the possibility that I murdered Hammer.
Right.
But that is only a possibility. Proof is another thing altogether. You lack decisive proof, Mr. Wright.
What?
Order! Mr. Wright, Mr. Edgeworth, your thoughts?
Of course, it's as the witness says.
Certainly, it does seem very likely she did it, but, there's no proof.
Edgeworth isn't sure?
Well, I came here as a witness today. If there are no more questions, I'll be leaving.
What do I do now? Testify again. I like you to testify again.
Testify again?
Know when to give up, Mr. Wright. Think about it. Even if I were to testify again, what's the point? I can only say what I said before. The truth, Mr. Wright. I've already said all there is to say. What would happen if I said it again? Yes, the same questions get the same answers. A waste of time.
Damn!
To come so far only to fail.
Rubble, you kind of suck at this shit, Rubble.
As it seems, there are no further questions. I would like to end the cross-examination of the witness, Miss Vasquez.
Oh, what? Edgeworth?
Yes, Mr. Edgeworth?
I was hoping to come up with a question while I was objecting your order. I didn't.
Oh, I see. Very well.
What the fuck?
Your honor!
I request that the witness testify again.
You are the prosecutor, are you not? Why are you badgering me? I'm your witness.
I just want to hear your testimony again.
Does this make any sense to you, Your Honor? I don't see that we have anything to gain by repeating the last several minutes.
Mr. Edgeworth, I too see little point in making Miss Vasquez repeat herself. What exactly do you want her to testify about?
Indeed, fairly I say, ergo, I want to hear about what happened after they found the body.
After they found the body? Very well. The witness will testify to the court concerning this matter.
Nick, why did Edgeworth?
Who knows? He probably realized she did it too.
But, wasn't he the one that said he always gets a guilty verdict? After all that?
Edgeworth? Yeah, he actually helped us in this one. Because not just we don't know we have any evidence to present, but he doesn't. So I guess both for the prosecution and defense were at an impasse. So the prosecution basically said, you know what? Why don't we ask a different line of questioning after finding the body?
I was with Sal and Olbag, the security lady, when we found the body. The assistant was there too. Only Powers was absent. I immediately called the police, and Powers showed up. the Curie Lady Oldbag was quite agitated, pointing at Powers, saying he did it. I asked to be left out of the proceedings. I went back to the trailer to get my script and direction notes. Then I went home.
So this is a truly the last testimony, then.
I see no issues raised by this testimony. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination.
Okay, Nick, we're close. Real close. She may be acting tough now, but if you put her on the spot, she's sure to falter. Find the key you need and twist the truth out of her, Nick. Right.
Here we go. When we found the body... Left out of proceeding. You asked to be left out?
Yes. It seems that everyone else was questioned. And I'm really not fond of that sort of thing.
But you can't decide who the police will and won't question.
Thankfully, the studio thinks otherwise. They were nice enough to understand that since we were in the meeting, there was no way we could have been involved. Thus, they covered for us.
Covered for you, or covered it up for you? There must have been a lot of writing on it with all those bigwigs at the meeting. I'm sure her professionals helped convince everyone they didn't require questioning. The script and your direction notes...
Yes, they're quite valuable. It wouldn't do to have them stolen.
No, I guess not. Wait a second. I thought you came to Studio One for a rehearsal. Why didn't you bring your script and notes?
Well, I was under the impression that we wouldn't be able to rehearse anything.
Why?
There was a murder, after all. Who could think of rehearsing after that?
Oh, yeah, I guess.
Very well, Miss Vadkes, please continue.
Wait a minute, Edgeworth?
Your Honor,
I have an objection to the witness's last statement. Edgeworth making an objection. Huh? Think. Miss Vadkes says she didn't bring the script because there wouldn't be a rehearsal. Don't you see what that means? She would have had to know about the murder before going to Studio One. Ah, what a great twist there that was. Rubble, rubble, what the hell, Edgeworth, rubble?
Order, order. Mr. Edgeworth, what you have just said is a reasonable observation. However, I find it hard to understand why the prosecution would make such a move. Or are you thinking of a career change to defense?
I appreciate the concern, Your Honor. I will stand by my statement, however, regardless of how the court sees my role here. Now, Ms. Vasquez, do you have an explanation?
I can't believe Edgeworth is helping me. So the prosecution is in cahoots with the defense? What kind of court is this? No matter. I think you misunderstood me. I had a perfectly good reason to believe there would be no rehearsal.
Very well. The witness will change her testimony to reflect this reason.
I knew that Hammer was injured and couldn't do any action scenes, so I left them behind.
This is it. Edgeworth saved the day. How about that? She said Hammer was injured. Hammer was injured? It wasn't Hammer. It was Powers. If she was really there at that rehearsal, she would have known about the injury, but she doesn't know about the injury. Objection. You knew that Hammer was injured? Don't you think that's a little funny? I mean, it was the Steel Samurai who was injured. It was Will Powers. What? Yeah, she didn't know.
Mr. Wright, explain yourself.
Yes, Mr. Hammer is dragging his leg in this photo, but that's because he was pretending to be Mr. Powers.
Pretending?
One person was injured in the run-through that morning. That person was Mr. Powers, not Mr. Hammer. Now, why did you think it was Mr. Hammer who was injured?
I already said it was Sal who told me.
That's right. He must have gotten it wrong.
I think not.
Mr. Manella was at the run-through that morning. He would have known it was Mr. Powers who was injured. He saw it happen. Why would he tell you the wrong person? Miss Vasquez, you saw Hammer limping. Actually, you didn't hear anything from Mr. Manella. You saw Mr. Hammer limping with your own eyes.
Yes, but wasn't Mr. Powers who was injured?
Yes, but remember, Mr. Hammer was dragging his leg too. He was pretending to be Mr. Powers.
Oh!
And when was he doing this?
Well, it would have been after he put on the Steel Samurai costume and went to the studio, too, where he was murdered.
Exactly. Miss Vasquez, you met him, didn't you? You saw the Steel Samurai limping. And Mr. Hammer was in that Steel Samurai suit. That's why you were confused. That's why you thought it was Mr. Hammer who had been injured that morning. Ah! Loving this. Rubble, rubble, rubble.
Order, order. I will have order.
Witness, can you refute this claim?
Yeah, let's see you sneak out of this one, Vasquez. Very well. I have a question for you. Why are the real killers always so persistent? Why in the world would I want Mr. Hammer dead? Yes, he'd fallen on hard times, but he was a star. I had nothing to gain from his death. Nothing.
Yes, you would need a motive. Why would she have killed the victim? If there is a reason, it is unclear to this court. Does the defense have anything to say on the matter? In other words, can you prove she had a motive?
Sorry, but we don't have proof, so I can't prove it. Oh, we can't prove it? Saying you can't prove it now would be admitting it. Oh, okay, my bad. Okay, I have proof and I'll show it to you. We're going to do the court evidence as to Ms. Keska's motive in this murder. This is my proof. I think it was this one. This is
the photo from before.
This photo reveals the motive in this murder. Oh, she's kind of surprised there. I'm right, aren't I, Miss Vasquez? Five years ago, Mr. Hammer was at the height of this fame. With Dee Vasquez's help, a terrible accident was swept under the carpet. Ladies and gentlemen, the case currently up for trial, it began on that day, 5 years ago. Ironically enough, that accident precipitated Mr. Hammer's fall. His fall from stardom. His guilt weighed him down, no doubt. However, you, Dee Vasquez, used Mr. Hammer. You made him work for you for petty change.
Bringing us to the present day and Mr. Hammer's last role as the evil magistrate.
Yes, undoubtedly it was a constant source of shame for the X-Star.
One moment, Mr. Wright. We are talking about motives here, yet you have only talked about Mr. Hammer. It almost seems as if it was Mr. Hammer who had killed Dee Vasquez, not the other way around. What motive Miss Vasquez would have?
Yes, that's right. According to what you say, I would have no reason to kill Hammer. He was a good source of income for me. And I never get rid of useful men. It's a policy of mine.
Mr. Wright, please explain Miss Vasquez's motive for murder.
She had no motive. She had no motive, Your Honor.
What's that now?
It was Mr. Hammer who was out for blood. All Miss Vasquez did was push him off the stairs in self-defense.
What's that now?
It's simple. Mr. Hammer was intending to kill Miss Vasquez.
What?
Yeah. Kind of a flip-flop scenario. Your Honor, Jackhammer drugged Mr. Powers with sleeping pills. Jackhammer snuck into the dressing room and stole the Steel Samurai costume. Jackhammer wore the costume to fool the security lady into thinking he was Powers. Then Jackhammer made his way to the trailer. And for what purpose, you ask? To kill Dee Vasquez, who had so cruelly taken advantage of him all those years. Oh, man. I think we could broke her down. So you did it. So you did do it, didn't you? How old is she? She's 34. Okay.
Yes, I am guilty. It was me.
So she killed him in self-defense because he wanted to kill her. Kill her, yeah.
Someone call an ambulance.
There's blood everywhere. We're too late.
Miss Vasquez. What happened here?
Manuel fell from the trailer stairs. Manuel.
Miss Vasquez, please try to remain calm.
No.
How could this? It was an accident.
Mr. Hammer was doing an action scene and...
No, Manuel! Don't touch him, Miss Vasquez. No! Please don't die. Please!
So it was true.
Congratulations, Mr. Wright. I lose. Again.
Rubble, what the fuck just happened, Rubble?
Mr. Edgeworth, where's D. Vasquez?
In the waiting lobby, Your Honor, as calm and collected as ever.
I see. Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
It appears you have brought about another miracle.
Thank you, Your Honor.
I think not, Your Honor. Will Powers was innocent.
That he should be found so is only natural, not a miracle.
Yes, you're right.
Very well. This court finds the defendant, Mr. Will Powers,
not guilty.
Yay!
That is all. This court is adjourned. Until Christmas.
I keep mentioning the Christmas joke.
I don't know what to say. Thank you so much.
I'm just glad you're okay.
Yes, but it's sad. I know now that Mr. Hammer stole my costume. It's bad enough that he wanted to kill Miss Vasquez. But to think that he would try to frame me for the murder, it makes me sad.
Tell me why, Mr. Wright. Huh?
Tell me, why did Mr. Hammer want to blame me?
Well, this is what I think. Mr. Hammer wanted to put the blame on you because you became the new star. And he got jealous of that fact. It's because you were the Seal Samurai.
Because I was a Seal Samurai?
Mr. Hammer was a big star once, but he was reduced to acting in a kid's show and as the villain to boot. The kids loved the Seal Samurai, and so he hated you.
I think I understand. He could have just told me. I would have changed places with him any time.
I think you're missing the point. Yeah. The point was is he wanted to be the main star again. Not let some new upstart outstage him.
Thank you. I'm just glad it's all over.
So am I.
Congratulations, WP.
Oh.
Thanks to you, I'll be able to don the Seal Samurai outfit once more. I can't wait to get back into that sweaty costume, man.
Is something wrong?
No, of course not. Ah! Nick, Edgeworth.
Well, hi, Edgeworth.
Say something, right? I'm not good at small talk.
Huh? What?
That was too bad, Edgeworth. You don't waste any time gloating, do you?
No, I really want to thank you. Vasquez would have gotten away if you hadn't stepped in.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Powers.
Edgeworth, I'm a big fan of your work, Mr. Powers.
Liar!
Right. I must say, I hadn't expected to meet you again after all these years.
Meet again?
However, in retrospect, it would have been better had we not met. Thanks to you, I am saddled with unnecessary feelings.
Unnecessary feelings?
Yes, unease and uncertainty.
Aren't those kind of necessary? They only serve to get in my way. You listen to me, Mr. God, my throat's fucked up. You listen to me, Phoenix Wright. Don't ever show your face in front of me again. That's what I came here to tell you.
Mr. Wright? Was that guy your friend?
What? Friends? As if? The rivals! Rivals, right, Nick? For now we are, I guess. Huh? Why do I get the feeling of missing something? Come on, Nick, tell me. What's the deal with you and Edgeworth?
And so the curtain closed on another trial. I caused quite a stir by revealing that accident from 5 years ago. It was the talk of the town. Thankfully, Global Studios rethought its programming change. They went back to making kid shows again.
Oh my god! They're doing the Pink Princess bullshit! Nick! This is it! The new show starts today! You're going to watch it with me, right?
I'll admit I was kind of surprised. I didn't think they'd seriously go through with it.
You have to buy training cards too, okay? We have to trade with Cody and that assistant.
Fine, fine. I'll do it.
Isn't it great that WP gets to play the lead again?
Oh my god! he's the Pink Princess!
I wonder if they'll show his real face this time.
I don't know. I don't think the world is ready for the real Will Powers.
Oh man, that's great. The end. That's great. Alright.
There's only two cases left in Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney.
That's crazy.
The next episode is called Turnabout Goodbyes. Save the game. What the hell's going on?
It's been what? 15 years?
About that?
Yes. 15 years is a long time to wait. You can't imagine how much I've suffered.
You've suffered?
But now, the perfect opportunity has presented itself. At last, I shall have my revenge.
What?
Merry Christmas.
Wait a minute. Edgeworth? What? He killed somebody? And look at it, it's actually on Christmas Day, 10:08 a.m., right in company law offices. I told you we'd be back up until Christmas.
Hey, Nick. Do you know if there are any good waterfalls around here?
Waterfalls? Dare I ask why?
Duh, Nick, isn't it obvious? I need a waterfall to stand under, preferably a freezing one.
Oh, is that part of your spirit medium training?
Of course, except I've been slacking off lately. I need to brave the elements and be forged anew under the rushing spring waters.
Okay. I don't know about any falls per se, but Gord Lake is pretty close.
Oh, darn. Sorry, but them's the breaks.
Couldn't you just take a cold shower or something?
Good idea.
So much for rushing for spring waters. Here we go.
Next in the news, a large unidentified animal was sighted at Gord Lake. The town is buzzing with excitement. Locals are calling it Gordy in a tip of the hat to Nessie the Loch Ness Monster. Though his namesake, Nessie, proved to be a hoax, locals are confident their Gordy is the real deal.
Boring.
Can't they show real news for a change?
Nick? The water pressure's kind of low in that shower.
You want more pressure, huh? Why don't you go down to the fire department and have them spray you with the hose?
Good idea, Nick. Oh my god,
Apparently, Fey blood is no aid in detecting sarcasm.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. Strange occurrences continue at Gord Lake, but this time it's a murder.
Gord Lake again?
The body of a man was found in the lake early this morning. A suspect was apprehended. Sources inside the police department revealed that the suspect's name is Miles Edgeworth, age 24. Edgeworth was an up-and-coming prosecutor known for his skill and connections. He was guaranteed a long and rewarding career. Has he thrown it all away?
Huh? Edgeworth?
What's going on? Edgeworth would never do something like...
Nick?
Yikes, Maya!
The fireman yelled at me when I called him.
We got bigger things to worry about than that. They arrested Edgeworth.
What? You mean the prosecutor?
Yeah, he's a suspect in a murder.
What?
When? Where? Whom? Why? How?
I don't know.
Let's go find out, Nick.
Well, we gotta go save Edgeworth to the detention center. If he wants to talk to us.
You know, Nick, we've all been in here one time or another, haven't we?
I guess it comes with the territory.
I'm not sure it's something we should mention it to too many people.
Oh, there he is!
Ah!
What the fuck?
Hey, Edgeworth, come back!
What are you doing here? Nick, I don't think he's in a very good mood.
Well, he is in detention. Were you in a good mood when you were in here?
So you come to laugh at the falling attorney?
Then laugh. Laugh! Well, why aren't you laughing?
Nick, should we be laughing?
Nah, it's a trick. Laugh and he'll get mad or burst into tears.
Edgeworth, we don't have so much free time we can spend it coming down here to laugh at you.
Yes, you do.
Actually, he's right.
I hoped you wouldn't come. I didn't want you to see me. Not like this.
I didn't want you to see me like this either, believe me.
Edgeworth, tell me what happened.
Why should I? What are you going to do about it?
Duh, we're going to help you, that's what.
Huh?
Help me? You?
Don't be ridiculous. Sorry?
You're a novice. You've only been in 3 trials.
Hey, sure you got lucky and won all 3, but your luck's bound to run out someday. You need real skill, right? Experience.
Nick, he's insulting you. Nick, why am I always the one who has to get angry?
The murder took place at Gord Lake, correct?
Yes, late last night.
The lake is a long way from your offices in the courthouse. Why were you down there?
I see no need to tell you.
Mr. Edgeworth, you didn't really...
Gordy.
Huh? I went to see Gordy.
Gordy? What's that?
I'll tell you later. Why won't Edgeworth talk to us?
Your attorney's badge?
Edgeworth, let me defend you.
Ha! Good one, right? But I'm not that hard up. Not yet.
What do you mean by that?
Me? Trust a whip behind the ears lawyer with only 3 trials under his belt? Never.
What?
My case is near hopeless, right? Every defense attorney I've talked to has turned me down.
What?
Simply put, they were afraid they'd lose. It occurred to me that it might be my fault that they lack confidence. After all, I did get every single one of their clients declared guilty.
I don't believe it. Regardless, I don't want you involved in this.
You in particular, I cannot ask to do this.
Did you do it, though? Edgeworth, this is really hard for me to ask, but you didn't do it, right?
Right?
Think what you will.
I have only one request. Stay out of this case.
Why? But Nick is trying to help you.
I know that. But I don't want your help, okay?
Why not?
Look, just go away and leave me alone.
Nick, Mr. Edward didn't he?
Maya, let's go investigate elsewhere.
But Nick...
There's nothing we can do here. Time to go to Gourd Lake. See if we can actually somehow get on here.
This is where it happened?
Yeah, Gourd Lake is in the middle of this park.
I can see some police walking around in here.
Questioning people, probably.
Hey, isn't that Detective Gumshoe over there?
Well, pal, there's enough of us here. Anyone found anything?
Aw, man. Right as soon as I get to Gumshoe's part? Come on. Gotta love this bullshit. Wait for it. Are you gonna pop up now, Elgato? Well, this is embarrassing. Close. Start up again. Come on. Device is in use somewhere else. Oh, come on. Are you for fuck's sake. Alright, give me a second here. I got to literally turn this thing off and turn it back on. Well, I turn it off and then turn it back on. My second monitor pops back up easily, but it's the main one on my computer that does not want to freaking come back on. Which doesn't make a lot of sense. So let's go ahead and close that again. Bring this back up. Oh, we got signal. All right, finally. Okay. Sorry, sir, nothing.
Idiot, the trial's tomorrow. We need clues on the double.
But, sir, there weren't any clues. That's why we arrested that attorney, Mr. Edgeworth. It's clear, sir, he's the one who...
Shut up. Just you try saying that again. I'll make you sorry if you do. So just get out of my face, pal.
Yes, sir. Detective Gumshoe's kind of scary today.
Sorry, that was Maya's voice, but...
Recruits! Puh! Ah!
Eh!
Hey, you're that hairy guy! Hairy Butts!
Right. Phoenix Wright. Will you ever learn my name?
And just what are you doing here, pal? Investigating?
Well, yes, I suppose.
Well, I'm here to help. Ask me anything you want. Bring it.
He seems different than usual. I wonder what's up. Mr. Ezra hasn't actually asked us to defend him yet.
Huh? Oh, you don't say.
Detective Gumshoe, do you know what happened here?
Huh? You don't know, pal?
No.
Well, okay, Mr. Head in the Fluffy Pink Clouds lawyer.
Head in the... Huh?
Never mind, I'll tell you. It happened last night about 15 minutes after midnight. There was a boat out on Gourd Lake. In that boat were two men. One of those men shot the other with a pistol. And the shooter... Oh, sorry.
And the shooter was Mr. Edgeworth?
A cop who arrived on the scene arrested him.
How did they get there so fast?
Well, There was a witness. When the report came in, we raced to the lake.
A witness? You don't think Mr. Edward is a murderer, do you?
Absolutely not. It's impossible. I don't care if there's a witness or either. I don't believe a lick of it.
Right. Who cares what the witnesses say? I care. Freaking Phoenix. You really believe in him, don't you, Detective?
Of course I do. But the police are pretty sure he's the killer. Nobody's even really taken this investigation that seriously.
Oh, no.
After all the help Mr. Edgeworth has been to us, hard to imagine that no one's standing up to take his side.
Well, at least you are, Detective. At least you are. Is it true? No one will take Mr. Edgeworth's case?
Yeah. He's a bit of a celebrity. If you defended him and lost, your reputation would be sure to suffer. What's more, the case against him is, well, it's pretty solid.
I suppose it would be if they had a witness.
Hey, pal, don't tell me you're going to turn your back on him, too. Remember the Steel Samurai case. Mr. Edgeworth helped you get your client declared innocent.
I know. I went to Edgeworth. I tried. He really doesn't want us to represent him. Especially not us, he said.
What? Well, that doesn't make any sense, pal. You should have heard him talking about you after that trial. He kept saying right, right, right over and over.
Nick, I'm not sure that's a good sign. Neither am I.
Why wouldn't he want your help? I don't get it.
Who was this witness?
Sorry, pal, that's confidential. Anyway, the witness saw everything, apparently. I'm sure they'll turn up at the trial tomorrow. Was there
only that one witness?
Yep, and it was pretty cold out on that lake last night. And it was Christmas Eve, after all. Still, we're being thorough. You never know when you're going to turn up another witness. That's why we're here today, checking things out. So far, we're coming up empty.
Oh, it's Christmas today. I've forgotten. What are you getting me for Christmas, Nick? Talk to Santa. Detective Gumshoes, sir.
Find anything?
No, sir, not yet. But there was a call from the precinct. They want to hold an investigation briefing.
A briefing? Right, I'm off. Oh, sorry, pal. I guess you heard. I gotta go. Any last things you want to ask me about before I head back?
The autopsy report. Well, yes. Do you have any information on the victim?
Sorry. They haven't worked up the autopsy report yet. I'm still waiting for it myself. Actually, say, if you get the time, drop by the precinct. We could talk more there, pal.
You're not coming back, Detective?
Probably not, pal.
So, what should we do if we have something to talk to you about?
Oh, right. Here, I'll show you how to get to the precinct. Come down and see me anytime.
Directions to the police station have been received from Detective Gumshoe. Oh, hey, Detective Gumshoe!
What?
We'd like to take a look around the park. Can we walk around?
Yeah, no problem, pal. You got my permission.
Cool. You know, Nick, I think there's something to be said for talking to people when they're busy. Yeah, they don't have time to think about not giving you information. Right. Now let's get investigating. All right, we can finally investigate. Let's go to the Gourd Lake Public Beach first. December 25th, Gourd Lake Public Beach. Wowzers, this is Gourd Lake? Yep. I'm not sure it warrants a wowzers, though. Probably not. But hey, look at that snack stand. Samurai dogs? I want a samurai dog, please. I bet they're great. With a name like Samurai Dog, how could they not be? They're a little behind the times, though. The kids are all into the Pink Princess now. I mean, like, you know? Nope. What the hell is this? Huh? Someone left some poppers here. You know. Oh, sorry, that was Maya. Huh? Someone left some poppers here. You know, you pull the string and it goes pop. Yeah, I know the ones. You see them a lot around New Year's. Hey, Nick, they might be a clue. Let's take them. Come on a minute. You just want to pop them, right?
Was it that obvious?
Poppers. Take them.
I suppose it couldn't hurt.
Huh? Where did they go?
Into my pocket.
She already knew that we're gonna take it. We actually gonna need that.
Lakewoods, huh?
Look at that, there's a camera with a huge microphone. And it says no camping over there.
I like it here, Nick. Look, someone's camping. They got guts camping at the scene of a murder. Hey, Nick. If they were camping here last night, they might know something about the murder.
That's true. Good call, Maya. Let's go talk to them.
This camera's a mic and some sort of attachment. It must take pictures when triggered by a noise.
Wow, cool. Let's try it out.
Hi, I'm Nick.
Maybe I'm not saying it loud enough.
Hey, I'm Nick.
Huh.
Nick,
will you stop that? Maybe it's broken? Don't kick it. Maybe it isn't set to respond to voices.
Well, what then? These things? The party poppers?
It went off all right.
Well, it responded.
Y'all! Hey, you! Get your hands off of that! What in the Sam Hill? Look what you've done now! There goes a whole roll of film! Sorry's nice, but it don't pay my bills. Y'all know how much my roll of that damn film costs?
I'll pay you back.
What were y'all thinking setting off a party popper at a place like this?
Well...
What? Don't try to play stupid with me just cause you think I'm some country bumpkin. I know how y'all Yanks think. I say those southern folk talk with that exaggerated drawl, why they must be dumb. Well, let me tell you, just because I might be dumb don't mean we all are.
Nick, help.
And who are you now? Her chaperone?
Yeah, no, rather, we're sort of friends.
Just figure out what y'all are gonna say and say it for Bajima's snake. God, I'd rather sit through one of them papa's draws and listen to you stutter all day.
Oh boy, I guess we should pay her for the film.
Watch it!
Yes, ma'am. On second thought, I'll pay later.
I'm really sorry.
What a character.
What? Can't y'all see I'm changing the film on my damn camera here? Someone, I'm not naming any names, but someone used up a whole roll.
God, and I'm using my throat's really feeling it. Oh God.
Sorry.
That didn't work. I wonder if I have anything to show her that would get her attention.
What? Can't you see?
Okay, she's gonna say the same thing over and over. I guess we're gonna present something.
This is my badge.
Huh?
Aren't badge supposed to be all shiny and impressive? You a cop or something?
I'm a lawyer.
What? Y'all ain't gonna try and pull one of them lawsuits on me over that film now. Cause I'll have you know I'm a fighter and I wrestled meaner looking things than you.
No, that's not it at all. We're here investigating a murder that took place here on the lake.
A murder? Sounds cool. Why did y'all say that in the first place? Go ahead, ask me anything you like.
Finally, some cooperation.
You too. Y'all can come out of hiding now, I won't buy hard.
Come to think of it, where did Maya get to?
Sorry.
I was feeling a little overwhelmed. The culture gap and all.
Never you mind, honey. I can talk Yank for you if it pleases you.
Thanks. I think I'll be okay.
Great then. I'm Lotta. Lotta Hart, but y'all can call me Lotta. I'm here photographing meteor showers for a research project. Mighty pleased to meet you.
Okay.
Oh yeah, when was that murder anyway? I ain't seen much television lately.
It happened late in the night of Christmas Eve.
That so? Christmas Eve?
A man on a boat was shot. Did you see anything?
Well, let me see. A boat, you say? I reckon I might have seen one, not sure or no. Y'all gotta remember, I've been watching this here lake for a good 3 days now. I ain't seen enough boats to choke a mule. Kinda hard to remember which I seen when.
So, what is it you do, Lotta?
Huh? Me? Y'all don't really want to know that, do ya? Actually, I'm a research student at Country U, right in the heart of the heartland.
Wow, neat. Nick, she's a research student at a university, Country U.
So I hear.
So when did you come up here?
Let me see. I guess it was about 3 days ago.
What are you photographing?
Didn't I tell you all that already?
Meteors, yep, meteor showers.
Fallen stars.
That's quite a camera you have there.
Y'all better know it, it's German made, a genuine Solingen.
Isn't that where they make knives?
So what's that device you have stuck to the camera?
Huh? Device?
Your camera went off all by itself when I fired my party popper.
Oh, that mic triggers the shutter whenever it detects certain sounds. It's programmed to pick out loud noises right now.
A programmable camera? Neat.
Yep.
Lotta?
Yeah?
So, your camera, it triggers on loud explosion noises?
Yep.
Actually, the victim in the case we're researching, he was shot with a pistol.
A pistol?
Right. Now, wouldn't a gunshot make a similar noise to our party popper?
I guess it would.
Your camera didn't get a picture of the murder, did it?
Hey, y'all are pretty bright. I see what you're saying. Tell you what, I'll have a look-see at my film.
It would have been a photo taken late last night.
I'd check them once, don't remember if there was any on them, though. But what if I got something? I could be a witness to a genuine murder. Yee-haw! I'll go check that film. Y'all come back now, you hear?
And there she goes. Where she went? She went inside her SUV. I guess we should come back later.
Being a southern country bumpkin. A boat rental shop?
Nick, what is this place?
A boat rental shop? Closed for Christmas, it seems. I guess a murder taking place on one of the boats won't be good for business either.
Boats? I've never ridden on a boat.
Really? Well, how about we go out on one when the trial is finished?
Hey, good idea. You bet.
Nothing here.
I guess Detective Gumshoe is still in that meeting.
Hey! Thanks for coming down, pal.
Detective Gumshoe.
We just finished the meeting, for better or for worse.
I get the feeling we're in for some bad news.
Do you know anything about the victim yet?
No, still can't ID him.
Has Mr. Ezra said anything?
Not a word.
Wow, that was short.
So, how did the meeting go?
I can't tell you, pal. You're a lawyer.
True.
You know, I don't know what to believe anymore. Sure, Mr. Edward's human like you or me. Still, I get the feeling that if he'd done something wrong, he wouldn't go hiding it. That's just the kind of guy he is. Wait, why can't anyone else see that?
So they think Mr. Edgeworth did it.
Well, the trial starting tomorrow as scheduled.
I see. Hey, in the end, you did tell us about the meeting.
Don't go telling anyone else, pal.
Yes, sir.
And do me a favor. Stand by Mr. Edgeworth. He needs help, and you're the ones to help him. I'm sure he's got some reason why he won't talk to us.
Thanks, Detective Gumshoe. Detective Gumshoe, how come you trust Mr. Edgeworth so much?
Well, I think that was obvious. We got a strong working relationship, us two. We trust each other, and that's how it works.
A working relationship?
See, Mr. Edgeworth always gets his defendants declared guilty every time. Yeah, his methods might be a little extreme at times, but there's a reason. He trusts our investigation, see? He trusts us to get the right man. That's why I work extra hard, pal. We've got to earn that trust he placed in us.
I see.
Mr. Edgeworth's a man you can trust, and you have my word on that.
What about the autopsy report?
I was wondering, did you ever get the autopsy report?
Oh, that? Yeah, I made a copy for you.
Sometime between on the 24th and 25th, caused a bullet shot to the heart.
Thank you. Nick, huh? Can you show me the photo of the victim? That face.
Someone you know?
I don't know. I just have this feeling that I met him somewhere a long time ago.
Well, I hope it helps you, pal.
Thanks, Detective. Okay, cool. We got some more information. Oh, there's an update.
Hey, y'all! Lotta! Wait up a sec, we got Bingo!
Bingo?
My automatic camera took 2 pictures last night.
Hey,
this is them. Take a look.
Wait.
See, he's shooting him with that pistol.
It looks like that, yes. But you can't really tell who that is shooting.
Yeah, well, there was enough fog out there last night to strangle a bullfrog. But you know, seeing these photos reminded me of something.
What?
I saw the murder happen. I'm a witness.
What?
Are you serious?
Of course.
How do you forget? Never mind.
Y'all reckon I should tell the cops?
I reckon so.
What's that? Now don't y'all go trying to mock my accent. I'm a sensitive lady. Hey, so I'm off to talk to the cops. Y'all can have this photo.
Later.
Wait, Lotta.
What? Can't y'all see I'm kind of busy?
Tell us what you saw too, please.
Nice try, honey, but I wasn't born yesterday. I'm a witness, and that means I'm on the side of justice, and that means the cops. I'd sooner eat the south side of a northbound skunk than tell you.
Lotta.
Don't let it get your skivvies in a bunch. Friends today, enemies tomorrow. Or was that the other way around? No matter, I'm gone. Hey, maybe they'll let me do some testifying. Hot darn. She left. Well, that's one more witness. What did we do now, Nick?
Well, if she saw something, there's not much we can do about it. The question is, what exactly did she see? I guess we'll find out in the trial tomorrow. We did get a picture, but she still has that other photo. Uh-oh.
Looks like the police have given up their interviewing.
Hey!
What the fuck?
Santa?
Ah! Nick, I think Santa's mad at you.
Long time no see, Nick. Nick? You know Santa? Wow, Nick and Saint Nick. Hey, I see the connection.
Don't be ridiculous.
Dude, it's me.
Oh, no! Larry? What are you doing here?
Isn't it obvious? I'm working my day job.
I sell samurai dogs. Want one?
Gotta get money for dates, you know. My girl Kianse deserves the best.
Kianse? Not another model, I hope. Oh, Kianse's a fine, fine woman, Nick. It was her idea that I wear this costume. She was all you. You go, girlfriend, you know.
She bought this costume for me. That's great, Larry.
Wow, a Santa costume. She must be really nice.
Whoa, cute.
Nick, who's she? She's not your...
Not my what?
No, she's not.
I'm his partner, Maya Faye. I'm, the little sister.
Sister?
Wow, Nick, must be tough. Working 9 to 5, having to take care of a little sister? No, I'm not Nick's sister. I'm my older sister's little sister. Huh, sounds great. Don't worry, Maya, he's not listening. What the hell is he doing here? Hey, Larry, there was a murder here last night. And since you work here, have you heard anything? Nick, you're wasting your time. Last night was Christmas Eve. He was with Kianci, obviously. He wouldn't have been standing out here in the cold. Ugh. Huh? I think what you just said caught him off guard, Maya. No, it's just... Kianci's not in town right now. She's in Hawaii on a photo shoot. A model? I knew it. Well, anyway, there was a murderer here on the lake. The trial's tomorrow. Huh. Neat. The defendant is Edgeworth. Miles Edgeworth. Nick? Why would Larry know Edgeworth? Whoa, Nick! You don't mean that Miles Edgeworth? Old Edgy? Yeah, he's a murder suspect. Whoa! Murder? Huh? You know Mr. Edgeworth, Larry? Yeah, of course. Edgy was in the same class as us in grade school. What? Dun, dun, dun. Tell me about the dogs. Huh? Oh, you mean the samurai dogs. Why are they samurai dogs? I mean, they kind of look gourd-shaped. Oh, originally they were gourd dogs. You know, like guard dogs? Ouch. The samurai thing was Kianse's idea. Oh, and she's my woman, you know. She was all changed the name and you go, girlfriend. She made me that banner. Man, the kids can't get enough of those samurai dogs. Something about that just seems wrong. Oh, and guess what? We're getting a ton of customers here at the lake with the big news. The big news? Yeah, Gordy. Gordy? First, let's do the Edgeworth one. So Mitchell Edgeworth was your classmate, Larry? Yeah, Nick, him, and I used to hang out all the time. Wow, I never knew. Don't get me wrong, he's always been kind of a stick in the mud. Studying all the time, trying to be like father. Like his father? Yeah, Edgy's pop was a famous defense lawyer back in the day. Wow. Wait, you said defense lawyer? Yeah. Wait a second. But Mr. Edgeworth's a prosecuting attorney. What? Edgy's got a proboscis on his knee? No, he's a prosecuting attorney. That's like the total opposite of a defense lawyer. Huh? Go figure. He always used to talk about defending the weak who were unable to defend themselves. Man, he used to go on and on about man's duty to society and all that. What a bore. I wonder what changed his mind, though. Do you know, Nick? Nick? He does, but he ain't saying anything. What's Gordy? Huh? You mean you don't know? It's here in this very lake. A giant mysterious monster. Gordy. A monster? Yeah. Check it out. This is an article from yesterday's newspaper. There's a photo. Wow, it's a really real. Look at that. Nick, a monster. A real monster. Yeah. It's probably just a log or something. Right? Hey. There's a quote here from the person who took the photo. What's this? I set the camera to automatic when we got into the frame. I heard a loud bang, like an explosion, followed by the sound of something slipping into the water. I wish I could have seen it. Why would there be a sound like an explosion? Larry, could I borrow this article from you? Sure, no problem. There'll be $1 million. $1 million? Grow up, Larry. $1 million for a newspaper? Get out of here. Okay, so can't really respond. What's this? You know, my eyes have been getting pretty bad lately, Nick. Actually, the photo's blurry, Larry. It was taken late last night. Last night? Okay. Bum, ba, na, na. Frickin' Larry.
Not a gumshoe in sight. If you're looking for Detective Gumshoe, he's in the questioning room. Apparently an important witness just turned up. He'll be in there a while. A lot of heart, it has to be.
Uh-oh.
What is it? Oh, nothing. Just something's been bothering me. Could you show me that autopsy report once more? Hey, I remember now. This guy, he's a lawyer that was at that office Mia worked at. I met him once when I went there to hang out with Sis. That office? Wait, you mean Grossberg's office? Right, that guy. That was the last name I expected to come up. Maybe I should go talk to him for old time's sake.
Well, guess what? That's where we're going. And the painting is still not there. Ahem! Ah, that old familiar clearing of the throat.
Aha! You're Mia's something, are you not?
I was your understudy, yes. Phoenix Wright.
Aha! And you're Mia's something, too, are you not?
Her little sister, yes.
You've grown. You've come to look a lot like your sister, you know. It takes me back. Ah, the days of my youth, like the scent of fresh lemon, you see.
Oh, welcome to the stream. Kothat Giacomo? Hopefully I say that right, sorry. Apologize. Mr. Grossberg, sir?
Hmm? Ah, yes, I beg your pardon. Of course you came here to discuss something. What is it then? Something the matter?
There was a murder last night.
A murder?
You haven't heard?
I just got up, you see.
Well, Miles Edgeworth shot someone with a pistol.
Edgeworth? What? Who did he shoot?
Well, the identity of the victim is still unknown.
This is terrible news indeed.
I guess he hadn't heard anything.
Mr. Grossberg, whatever happened to that painting?
Oh, yes. I do not think it shall ever be coming back home to this office. I can't exactly claim it as stolen. I suppose it's my just desserts. Old bitter desserts.
How about we present the autopsy report?
Strange. I feel as though I've seen this man somewhere before. Ah!
Did you remember?
He was a lawyer in my office. Here, in my...
Man, I'm fucking this up.
He was a lawyer here in my office. That's Hammond. Robert Hammond.
Mr. Hammond?
And you say this is the man Miles Edgeworth shot?
Yeah.
Who is this Hammond guy anyway?
Mr. Hammond. He was the defense attorney in that case.
That case?
Yes, the DL6 incident.
DL6? Why does that sound so familiar? It's from back in the second case.
Perhaps you remember?
I'm sure someone mentioned it during the trial of Mia's murder.
That was the incident where the police were so at a loss they used a spirit medium.
Ah! Wait, you don't mean... Was that medium my mother?
Yes, my dear. The spirit medium, Misty Faye, your mother, contacted the spirit of the victim. But the case was a loss. No conviction was made. The DL6 incident, yes, happened 15 years ago.
A very strange case indeed. They never caught the criminal, right?
Correct. Missy Faye used her powers to talk to the spirit of the late victim. Her testimony led to charges being laid against one man. But Mr. Hammond won the case and the suspect was declared innocent.
And the police blamed my mother, calling her a fraud. You were the one who helped her out then, right, Mr. Grossberg?
Yes. Yes, quite.
Thank you.
No, please. Don't mention it.
DL6. Never thought I'd hear that name again.
But wait. What does that case have anything to do with Mr. Edgeworth?
It has everything to do with Mr. Edgeworth, my dear. The victim of the DL6 incident was none other than his father.
Gregory Edgeworth.
What? His father?
If you want to know more, you should ask him yourself. Show him this. I'm sure he'll talk to you.
Wait. This is a photograph of my mother.
Misty Fay. Well, we know where to go now.
What's this? I was hoping you got my message the first time. Edgeworth, what about your defense? It's no concern of yours.
Guess he hasn't found anyone yet. Let's present that photo. Edgeworth?
It's only been a matter of hours since you last visited. Yet you've made incredible progress in your investigation.
I'll admit it, I'm impressed, right? You were always single-minded in your work, though. Once you start on something, you always see it through, don't you? About the DL6 incident.
Right. DL6. I didn't want you to find out about it. That is why I refuse your offer to defend me. I'm sorry if it sounded like I thought you weren't up to the job. I just wanted to keep you away from DL6.
So, do you still think it would have been better for me to stay away? I don't know.
But I see no point in hiding anything from you now. Very well. Ask whatever you like, and I will answer to the best of my abilities.
Well, we're finally getting somewhere.
The DL6 incident was when my father died.
Whoa.
Right before my eyes. He was shot and killed, and I saw it all. My memories from that time are foggy. I suppose it's a self-defense mechanism. In any case, a suspect was arrested, a man. It's pretty clear he was the only one who could have killed my father. The spirit medium they used to talk to my late father said the same thing. It was an attorney by the name of Robert Hammond that cleared the suspect's name. And Hammond is a victim in the Gord Lake murder?
Correct.
That spirit medium, that was my mom.
What? You mean you're... It's strange. I thought that terrible incident was about to end, and now this.
About to end? The DL6 incident happened 15 years ago. 15 years ago, on December 28th. December 28th? The statute of limitations on the case runs out in 3 days.
What?
Nick, what does that mean? When a case statute of limitations runs out legally, the case never happened. 3 days from now, DL6 will be closed forever.
What happened to the suspect, the one who got off innocent?
I don't know. He disappeared from the public view. Nobody knows where to. If he's still alive, he'd be about 50 years old now. I guess I can understand why he'd go into hiding. It'd be hard to live a normal life after being a murder suspect in such a big case.
So was your father a lawyer?
He was. Gregory Edgeworth. He was quite famous at the time, apparently.
So you were sort of trying to follow in his footsteps?
I'd rather not talk about it. Who would have thought there would be a photo?
Edgeworth, did you shoot him?
What do you think, right? I don't think you're the kind of point a gun at anyone, no.
So you didn't shoot him?
No, I didn't. It wasn't me.
Right.
It pains me to ask you this now.
I know, you want us to defend you.
Yes, will you?
Of course.
Ah, who could have guessed this day would come?
Not me.
This is my chance to finally pay you back. Pay him back?
Pay me back?
For what?
I don't remember ever doing anything for you.
Never mind. I guess you don't really need to know.
Huh?
My letter requests, please give it to Detective Gumshoe.
Well, I guess we should...
What's that?
Earthquake, Nick! It's a big one! Why?
It's calming down? Whew, that was scary. Huh? Where's Edgeworth? There! He's on the floor in the ball shivering. I guess he doesn't do so well with earthquakes. I've heard of running, but curling up in a ball? Well, I guess we're done. Mr. Edward doesn't seem like he's going to stand up anytime soon. Let's go, Nick. Right. We have to give Edgeworth's letter of request to Detective Gumshoe.
What's going on here?
What's wrong, Detective?
This wild lady comes in here just a while ago. Says she came to talk to y'all after hearing what Mr. Wright had to say. What's this all about, pal?
Lot of heart.
Why are you going around finding more witnesses? You want to give Mr. Edgeworth the death sentence, pal?
No, not at all. She did see something. There's nothing I can do about that. I can't go around covering up evidence. That's a fact.
You trying to say something about the way I do my job?
No, sir. So what did Miss Hart say?
She said she saw Mr. Edgeworth fire the pistol.
What?
She even had a photograph to prove it.
Right. I saw it too. But you really can't tell from the photo who it is shooting.
That's why she says she's going to enlarge the photo. She said it will drop the quality a mite, but should let us see who's who.
She can do that? Okay, so there's going to be an enlarged photograph that shows Edgeworth in the act. Great, just great.
In any case, she's going to be the one testifying tomorrow.
Huh? What happened to the other witness?
Well, apparently there was a cancellation.
A cancellation?
I'm afraid tomorrow's going to be life or death for poor Mr. Edgeworth. We got a witness who says she saw the very moment of the murder. And we got a photo taken when the shot rang out.
I say that sounds like a pretty unwinnable case. But wait, what did Mia used to say? If he's innocent, there's got to be something I've overlooked.
It sounds like Mr. Edgeworth's going to ask the state to assign the public a public defender. I was just asked to file the paperwork. We still got time, pal. Go talk to him again for me, please. You have to convince him. You have to make him let you defend him. Please. I know you're the only one who could do it, pal. You're the only one who could save Mr. Edgeworth.
Well, we have the said thing. Look what I got.
Hey, you did it, pal. Glad I waited till the last minute to file those papers. I'll rip them up and start new ones for you.
Thanks, Detective. Well, see you in court tomorrow, then.
Good luck, pal. Hey, you guys feel that earthquake a little while back? I was worried.
Worried? We're fine. I lived out here my whole life. I'm pretty used to them by now.
Oh, I wasn't worried about you two. I was worried about Mr. Edgeworth.
Oh, right. He did seem to overreact a little now that you mention it.
Yeah, well, I'm not surprised. It was a pretty big quake. I'm gonna go check up on him. You two go eat and go get your rest for tomorrow's trial. Later.
I wonder what it is with Mr. Edgeworth and earthquakes. I wonder. He was never that scared of them when he was in school. Then again, I only really got to know him in fourth grade. He transferred to another school after that. I wonder what happened to Edgeworth. To be continued. All right. Wow. That lasted longer than I thought. Damn. My throat's almost shot right now. All right. Well, I hate to cut this stream short, but as usual, I got to keep them short to rest up my throat. So...
But don't worry, I will make sure to do more streams and most definitely get through Phoenix Wright as quickly as possible. That will be ready for Apollo Justice Ace Attorney Trilogy. So that will do it for today. Thank you guys for watching who watches as a stream or as a recording. Please leave a like, subscribe, and a
comment down below, and of course, hit that notification bell to basically stay into the notification when I get to stream next and all that. More Phoenix Wright, of course, and with Christmas around the corner. And of course, Thanksgiving's actually around the corner first, and then next will be Christmas. So, yeah, pretty much being super busy. And there's nothing much I can really say. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Peace.